Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome to Development Diary number 2 for Jurassic World Evolution 2, titled An Authentic Jurassic World Experience. If you want to jump straight to that, that starts in a minute and 40 seconds, as you can probably tell on the screen. But I thought we'd do a little bit of an introduction before we get going. Now, the plan was definitely to stream this. Unfortunately, as I'm sure you're here, you're tired of hearing me say at this point, I am still in a bit of a messy setup. I'm recording on a dining room table. I don't have a second monitor. It's just really not made for streaming. However, hopefully by mid next week, by next Thursday, let's say, I should be back to normal in that case, and I should be able to stream stuff like this again going forward. That said, what we're going to do, we're going to waste about a minute of your time, and then we're going to watch the Dev Diary 2. Very exciting, the first Dev Diary revealed like 4 or 5 new dinosaurs. Well, I say new, like ones that we hadn't seen. Oh, hello. Ones that we hadn't seen in Evolution 2 yet, so that's all very exciting. And hopefully we get some new species today. It's meant to be about an authentic Jurassic World experience, but the preview image looks like Jurassic Park San Diego, which is of course something we saw a while back in the trailer. So very excited to hopefully see that come to life in a little bit, but we shall have to wait and see. But we're going to watch it right here, react to it as we go. I will let the whole thing play. I'm not going to talk over it. It'll be a pain in the ass. But once that's done, we'll go back through it. We'll break it down. We'll do our usual YouTuber kind of nonsense. Very excited. 20 seconds. I can kill 20 seconds. I've killed thousands upon thousands of hours of my YouTube career, so I can kill 20 seconds. Look, I've done 7 of them already. Just talking about how much time I'm killing is indeed killing time with this very dramatic countdown, which is absolutely not Jurassic World themed or appropriate at all. I love it. It's like a piece of pop art. Here we go.
Hi, I'm Rich Newbold. I'm the game director on Jurassic World Evolution 2, and we're here to talk to you about our most captivating and authentic Jurassic World experience yet.
Whoops.
Many of us on the game team have grown up with the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World movies in our lives. As a child, I watched Jurassic Park in the cinema and I fell in love with the dinosaurs on the screen. And then as an adult watching Jurassic World, it was so exciting. And this is a great opportunity for us to be part of that franchise and work alongside Universal and build upon the universe that they've created in the films, but allow us to use those iconic characters and dinosaurs and craft our own narrative for players to enjoy.
To us, the Jurassic World franchise is about capturing that sense of awe and wonder when you see a dinosaur for the first time. And I think that's something really magical about this franchise that we really wanted to bring to Jurassic World Evolution 2. Hi, my name is James Stant, and I'm the dialogue manager on Jurassic World Evolution 2.
In this Dev Diary, we're going to show you how we're bringing our authentic experience in 2 of our game modes, Campaign and Chaos Theory. We're really excited to show you what you can expect.
Both the Campaign and the Chaos Theory mode are set in the Jurassic World universe.
Jurassic World Evolution 2's Campaign mode is set in the aftermath of Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. The dinosaurs are no longer confined to Isla Nublar and are now wild across the United States of America. That freedom is now creating dangerous situations that the player is going to have to handle. I'm Dan Davies. I'm a principal designer on Jurassic World Evolution 2.
The player is recruited by the government agency, who are responsible for tracking down these dinosaurs and safely capturing them. And it's not just about the safety of the people, it's about the safety of the dinosaurs too.
The player will be in charge of this initiative, working for the Department of Fish and Wildlife, as they work alongside iconic franchise characters.
We're bringing back characters that players are going to recognise from the Jurassic World movies. Claire Deering and Owen Grady have been hired for their expertise in dealing with dinosaurs in these kinds of situations. They're going to accompany you as you travel around the United States, capturing and containing the dinosaurs now out in the wild.
We are so excited to be bringing back some of our own characters. We have Dr. Kajal Dua, Isaac Clement, Cabot Finch and George Lambert. These characters will provide support and guide the player towards success.
The player's role in campaign mode is very different to the other modes that we have in the game. Instead of focusing on building theme parks and using the dinosaurs to make as much money as possible, they're now dealing with the dinosaurs that are in the wild across the United States. This involves capturing them and then safely containing them in facilities that the player has built.
Hello, my name's Adam Woods and I'm the executive producer on Jurassic World Evolution 2.
As you can imagine, the player will face a number of challenges. The dangerous dinosaurs are just the beginning. They will be facing calamities, snowstorms, sandstorms. We are also introducing a number of new injuries and illnesses that can affect the well-being of the dinosaurs, and these will be another obstacle that the player will have to face.
This is completely uncharted territory. They're away from the confines of tropical islands, away from the Jurassic World gates. This is completely new, it's bigger, and it's more challenging for the player.
Chaos Theory mode allows players to be a part of the Jurassic World franchise. Alternate timelines explore how key events could have panned out differently now that the player is in a decisive role.
The players will experience a what-if scenario from each of the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World movies. They'll be in charge of either building a theme park or a facility based on that movie. For example, in the Lost World Jurassic Park scenario, they're going to try to succeed where others have failed and bring the San Diego part to the masses.
Chaos Theory mode for us was really exciting as developers because it was a great opportunity for us to go back to movies that we've really loved and grown up with and provide players that opportunity to go and experience these what-if scenarios and wish fulfillment of being in those moments from the films as they have their own impact in what's happening in these scenarios.
Across both campaign and Chaos Theory mode, the player is going to be encountering a large number of prehistoric species. We've worked really hard to ensure the species are authentic to the level or scenario that you're in. For example, you'll be coming face to face with the Indominus Rex in the Jurassic World Chaos Theory scenario. I'm really looking forward to the players enjoying these up-close moments with the dinosaurs from the ground level. It really gives a unique and different perspective to the scenarios.
I'm very excited to see players experience these new original stories that we've crafted in campaign mode and Chaos Theory mode, seeing dinosaurs in new locations as they work alongside these characters and the stories that we've created.
I'm really excited for players to experience these iconic characters in our original story.
I'm really excited about the players experiencing the Chaos Theory scenarios and making these iconic movie moments their own, whether it's bringing Jurassic Park San Diego to the masses or building their own version of Jurassic World.
Jurassic World stories are so iconic, and we are very proud to have created our own to be part of that, and we're looking forward to sharing that with you.
Right, are we done? Are we done, Denzel Washington? 9th of November, folks. That is creeping up very quickly. I reckon we're done. Okay, so can I just go back now? Yep, sweet. Okay, so let's get back to the start of that, break down what we saw, because we saw, I believe, two new species. I think that was it. One of them, though, brand new entirely, and one of them, of course, returning from the last game and the films. James Stan has shaved his mustache, which is deeply upsetting. do I have any other comments straight away? The campaign sounds really interesting. If I had to wager a guess, if you played Jurassic World Evolution 1's campaign, it was really long. You know, if you did everything, if you maxed out every division on every level, it took quite a long time. 20, 30 hours, if not more. I would wager, based on how this campaign is sounding, that it's going to be quite a bit shorter. Like they said, we're not building theme parks. We're not trying to make money from these dinosaurs in the campaign. We're trying to research them. We're trying to protect them from, you know, getting poached or something. You know, we're just trying to contain them so that Allosaurus can't roam around and then go eat Timmy, the little kid who lives down the lane. Timmy doesn't want to die. Timmy's got his whole life ahead of him. So you need to stop that Allosaurus. And that sounds very interesting. It's definitely a whole new direction to go in. I'm very excited to explore that. But I imagine it will be shorter overall. But then you take the, so we're taking away that park building element, and it sounds like that's basically being put into Chaos Theory mode, whereas Chaos Theory mode puts us into these locations and says, you know, gives us some unique stuff to do with the films and says, build a park, do it better than they did. We'll dig in more into that as we go through. Let's just go through bit by bit. I'm going to turn it down this time. And I'm going to skip forward to the dinosaurs. And see if we see anything new. We can see the Brachiosaurus. This is Washington, I believe. This is the campaign mission that I played on the channel fairly recently. It looks very, very similar. So we've got the Brachy, we've got the trike bounding along, looking adorable. I'm just going to try to go through each of the themes. So this is it. This is San Diego. You can see San Diego, the city itself, there in the distance, way off in the back. You can see the amphitheater, whatever you'd call it, the Jurassic World San Diego thing, Colosseum-esque building. We're going to get a better look at that, though. But you can see lots of different buildings here. What's really interesting, if you look at this, this looks to be viewing centers and stuff like that, but they've got like a little bit of Return to Jurassic Park kind of flair to them. You can see these thatched roofs. These buildings here have like this sort of darker wood going on with them. It's kind of like what Return to Jurassic Park did, wherein it wasn't meant to be necessarily set during Jurassic Park. The idea was modern buildings with a bit of Jurassic Park flair. And yeah, we're seeing yet more types of viewing area. This is the third type of viewing thing we've seen. I really hope we get access to all of them in sandbox mode. That would be really cool. Turn up a little bit. Carnotaurus here, doing a lovely little woo, woo. Let's just watch that again. Work alongside Universal, build little ballet spin that they've created in the films, but allow us to use those iconic characters. What I really like about that is we've seen this a few times now. We saw it with, say, the Coelophysis, for example. As they walked past each other, they had a little snap at each other. It seems to be like the dinosaurs have just this little interaction that they can play off each other every now and again. It's an interesting idea. We kind of saw it with the Rexes, the nudging. This right here, so that is quite clearly, unless I'm utterly, utterly crazy, that is quite clearly not the Mosasaurus, right? I'm going to go ahead, I mean, we don't know, I don't have the information in front of me. I strongly suspect that's meant to be a Tylosaurus. I think that's what that is. I'm just going to go check what the rest of the internet thinks before I make myself look stupid. I'll be back in a second. Some people are suggesting some other mosasaurs. It's a type of mosasaur. We don't know the specific species quite yet. It could be Bacillo, could be Tylo. My money's... I don't know. I'm going Giphy now. It could be any number of mosasaurs, but it's a new mosasaur either way. It's always a little difficult to predict what a Jurassic World species is that's a new one because, you know, they've always got a little bit of artistic license. But this would be our 5th aquatic species. I suspect it might well be the last. Also, apparently people have seen compies in this video, and I apparently completely missed them, so... Alright, there's our Tyrannosaurus Rex again, a much better look at the San Diego Amphitheater. I can hear a squeak. That is definitely a compie squeak. I'm going to turn it up just so you can hear that.
Capturing that sense of awe and wonder when you see a dinosaur for the first time.
Am I meant to see a compie there? I can definitely hear one, but I can't see one. Okay, so Dead Diary actually kicks off. So this looks like another campaign mission, this time in Arizona instead. They've gone and fetched these stegosauruses from the wild, ensure they've got 90% comfort, ensure they're visible from a research viewing facility. So it's kind of like the campaign we were already playing, but maybe a little bit more focused, a little bit more directed, less about making money and using shops and stuff like that, more about capturing the dinosaurs. It's just a different slant. A different stunt, eh? Sorry, on the same thing, I suppose. Interesting looking. Brachiosaurus looking absolutely gorgeous, as per usual. Absolutely stunning. Look at them. Don't they look fantastic in this environment? And I've got to say, the Rex back in that desert environment looked really cool as well. Definitely a worry I had that maybe the desert environment would just be a little bit too weird, you know, the lack of trees and stuff like that. You know, this is, okay, it's cold and frigid, it's very unlike Jurassic World, but... it's got trees, it's got forest, desert is very different, but you know what, it seemed to fit in really nicely. This is all Washington, we've kind of seen all this. I'm Dan Davies, that's a great name. Get a little bit of Allosaurus there using its, so this is the same skin pattern we saw the last time. Maybe with a bit more edging around it, but obviously the colour is completely different. Last time we saw those bright blue spots on the very orange Allosaurus, this is a much more tame colour. Sandy, browns, dusky sort of colours, and then the spots themselves, which we don't know how many colours they will have, but that's always the pattern you'll get for the Allosaurus. Maybe it's 7 or something like that is the prediction right now. But Allo's looking fantastic. I know a lot of people want to see the Battle of Big Rock Allo, which looks very different. I prefer this one personally. I find the Babber one, as we shall call it, the Babber Allo is a little bit monstrous in some ways. It suited Babber, but for Evolution 2, I actually really like this Allosaurus. I know that's mildly controversial. He's learning to fly. Look at this animation, little scritch scratch. I want to see it again. Little scritch scratch. Wait for it. Little scritch scratch, his neck has a little wobble, he lifts his tail up. You know, it's a whole... it's what I always like about the animations in Evolution 2. It's not like a dinosaur scratches itself on the chin, which is really cool, by the way. It's just a really nice ambient behavior. But then, you know, the whole body reacts to it. It's not just contained to that one part. Like, they always look at how the entire body would move in response to these animations. I think their work on Planet Zoo probably really helped them with Evolution 2. So yeah, this is still Arizona. As we said, we've got await delivery of the captured stegosauruses. And by the sounds of it, we'll be doing the capturing ourselves. And then we've got to isolate them from the other dinosaurs, which I'm assuming is the Allosaurus then, over here at this side. We can't actually make anything out over there. We're bringing back characters that players are going to recognize. There's a lovely Stegos. Claire Deering and Owen Grady. We knew all these characters were coming back. That's Baryonyx. Interesting little tidbit there. I don't know if we'd actually heard about this, but we knew dinosaurs had a sand requirement for their terrain. You know, to make them happy, they needed a certain amount of sand. We'd seen that. I don't think we'd seen missing rock before. I don't think we'd ever seen them missing rock specifically. So that's really interesting as well. So between sand, rock, you know, ground fiber and ground leaf with the herbivores, all your general open space requirements and your forest requirements and your prey requirements, that's a new one as well. Building the right habitat for your dinosaurs to be happy is going to be much more involved than it was in the past. Whereas in the past, it was just, there's a square of grass, there's some forest, yeah, done. Wetland helped that out a little bit, but now, obviously, it's much more detailed than that, which is always a good thing, I think. Back to Washington, not going to find anything new here, I don't think. Although, again, just pointing out these new buildings, because we have seen the old Jurassic World-style ones as well. So there's these ones, there's the Jurassic Park ones, and there's the Jurassic World ones.
We are so excited to be bringing back some of our own characters. We have Dr. Kajal Dua.
Is anyone excited about those characters? Maybe somebody out there absolutely loves Kajal Dua. I don't know. It's just not me. The player's role in campaign mode is very different to the other modes that we have in the game. Just let him talk for a second as I process my thoughts. Where have people seen this Compsognathus? have I gone crazy? I'm going to have to find out. This involves capturing them and then safely. Is it just because of the squeak?
Hello, my name's Adam Woods.
Hi, Adam Woods. Good looking guy, Adam Woods. Let's put it out there. As you can imagine, the players, as they all are, Frontier is just a company of lookers. Dinosaurs are just the beginning. It will be facing any gameplay. Oh, we're about to get there. So, is this our first proper look at sandstorms? I think it might be. We had heard about these in the past. Of course, we know snowstorms are going to be a thing as well. They're going to kind of, you know, we're not just going to have the twisters like we had in the past. We'll now have snowstorms, we'll have sandstorms. They'll knock out your fence, seemingly. Or maybe this agitated the, I think this is a Baryonyx, actually. Maybe this agitated the Baryonyx enough to break it out. Understandably, for a dinosaur, you know, can't cover its eyes, doesn't have a mask on or anything, a sandstorm's going to be pretty bad to suffer through. That would be very agitative. Maybe you can also knock out your power, and that of course renders it easier for your dinosaurs to break out as well. Sandstorms. We are also introducing a number of new injuries and illnesses. There's our paleobotany system. We saw all this in Washington. That's the same dino. Another obstacle that the player will have to face. This is completely uncharted territory. Away from the love the look of the, look at that. Wait. I know people love this. I just want to point it out. The sitting down Carnotaurus animation. We've seen it before and it's adorable. Just wanted to mention it again. So yeah, this is the Washington thing we saw. The blizzard going on. The trikes wandering around in the wild. You had to go capture the Allosaurus. Really good look at the amphitheater. It does look absolutely stunning. These big exhibits curling all around it as well. And look, this exhibit, you can see the back of the amphitheater opens up into this massive exhibit that sort of crosses this whole area around here at the back. And this building over here looking very much like the Return to Jurassic Park one as well. But that's really cool. So hopefully, I mean, we saw it in the trailer, right? But hopefully we will be able to actually include the amphitheater as, like, it acts as a wall. It does have, you know, pathways, which suggests, you know, people will be able to sit here and view the inside. And then you kind of just tie it in with the rest of the habitat and hope your dinosaurs walk in. Maybe lure them in with some food or something like that. That would be awesome. Hopefully it's a view as well. Like, we can click it and view from the amphitheater. Players to be a part of the Jurassic World franchise. And hopefully we can put it down ourselves in Sandbox. Extra little thing I forgot to mention. That would be awesome as well. Looks like a Rex habitat. That's a brown Rex. That's a green Rex. It's a green Rex. It's the Lost World Jurassic Park. It's a little bit far away to say anything definitive, so I'm not going to. But let's just say that's a promising idea. I'm sure you know why. Now that the player is in a decisive role. The players will experience a what-if scenario from each of the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World movies. They'll be in charge of either building a theme park... We only know San Diego so far. We're about to get a new image very soon. There we go. There's our classic tour vehicles back again. What I want to know... There's still a driver in the front bloody seat, I think. They need to get rid of that. I think there's a driver. It's hard to tell. But there was in the last game. There's some Pachycephalosauruses. So we've seen a Rex. We've seen a Pachycephalosaurus. We think we've heard a Compi. That would all make sense. You know, these are dinosaurs from the Lost World Jurassic Park. It would make sense for them to be there in The Lost World Jurassic Park. These tall, are they pounds? Oh, there's a massive fence over. It just looks fantastic. I love it with the lake in front of it as well. It actually feels a bit like the original visitor center, you know, with the tour vehicles going past and the lake and the big old building. These should actually be inverted, but still.
Jurassic Park scenario, they're going to try to succeed where others have failed and bring the San Diego Park to the masses.
Chaos theory mode for...
Bring the San Diego Park to the masses. It's a great opportunity for us to go. God, I've been doing this video for ages already. So it's just so much to talk about. Our T-Rex signs are back, so that's our first look at the signs slash... Well, it's not our first look, but it's a look at the signs slash decorations, which is cool. Right. Anything new here? This is Isla Nublar, I'm assuming this is the idea. The idea is that this is Jurassic World. We can see here we've got a Mosasaurus Lagoon. We've got Main Street here in front of this. We've got the aviary over on the side. I suspect they've made it to look somewhat like Jurassic World, and when you come back here in Chaos Theory mode, that will be the plan. Got the hotels over there on the side. It's a pretty great Jurassic World recreation, especially with the way the monorail curves over the entire thing. And of course, this confirms properly, we've seen it now, the return of the tropical biome. But also, as we've said for a while now, we kind of knew they were coming, but this beast, turn up for this bit.
Have their own impact in what's happening in these scenarios.
Across both campaign Ready and Chaos it. Theory mode, the player is going to be encountering a large number of prehistoric species. We've worked really hard to ensure the species are authentic to the level or scenario that you're in. For example, you'll be coming face.
Okay, that looks lovely. That's fantastic. But
the Indominus Rex.
Yeah, Indom has had a little bit of a glow up, I would say. Texture-wise, it looks fantastic.
You'll be coming face to face with the Indominus Rex in the Jurassic World Chaos
Theory. Absolute stunner. Still got that same noise, that kind of eerie alien-esque roar, but look at the skin detail, look at the individual scales you can make out. It looks fantastic.
Coming face to face with the Indominus Rex in the Jurassic World. I'm really looking
forward. You've got to remember, so even though we're just building in, look at him, doesn't he look stunning? Looks really good, actually. I'm quite excited about that. There's just like an extra level of detail. Of course, moving on to next-gen consoles and PCs obviously helps a lot with that. I love the I keep forgetting what this is called, you know, the membrane of skin. As a dinosaur opens its mouth and it kind of connects the two jaws together. I keep forgetting what it's called. I think it's like muscular. But it looks really nice as well. It's got this beautiful texture to it. I don't know. It's looking fantastic. The eyes are great as well. One of the things I'm, it's weird to say, but most excited about for this game is the eyes. They feel like they've been upgraded across the board. The tongue is sexy and pointed and droops down and very, very well textured and dramatic looking as well. And it's going to be really cool to build on Isla Nublar. You can see all this new foliage here. We've got palm trees. We've got these staggered palm trees as well. We've got all the old trees from the other thing. We're going to have rocks now that we can place and rotate properly and stuff like that. So even though we may be building Isla Nublar again tropical again, we're going to have all these new terrain options and requirements that are hopefully going to make it more interesting. There's the good old concrete fence. Although it's slightly different. You can see there's this kind of rut of metal at the top of the fence. We're used to end kind of like straight in concrete.
Chaos theory scenario. I'm really looking forward to the players enjoying these up. Really good.
Where's this bloody compy at? Right, I'm gonna go have one more check on the interwebs. Bear with me. Okay, I finally found the bloody compy. It's here. You can see it bounding along the ground just here. Look in the bottom left of the corner. I'm gonna let the video play so it gets rid of the UI. Look in the bottom left over here. You'll see it very briefly.
They'll be in charge of either building a theme park or a facility.
Wait for it. Bottom left. For example, there it is. Go, little compy. Go, bound. Do you see it? I can bring it up and pause on it now. Side bloody know where it is finally. Well, now I can't see it anymore. Yeah, there it is. There. Over there, bottom left corner. Compsognathus also confirmed. So compy, indom. Two new species confirmed, and... Well, we already confirmed Compy. What am I on about? I confirmed it in my bloody video. But now it's part of the park, I suppose, rather than wild. I guess that's different. And, whatever that Mosasaur is. It could be, honestly, there's about 7 or 8 different Mosasaurs it could be. If not, there's so many species it could be. So, can't say for sure what it is, but it's very exciting either way. Hope you've enjoyed this. This was a really cool little dev diary. Very excited about the Colosseum. Hopefully, some of the other Chaos Theory modes get their own version of this. You know, T-Rex Kingdom for Jurassic World. Maybe like a destroyed visitor center for Fallen Kingdom. Just one big building to really tie them all together. That would be awesome. But we'll have to wait and see. Also worth noting, it's now beta, not alpha. So the game is pretty much done, as you would expect. Beta tends to be more bug fixing and stuff like that rather than necessarily adding content. But we'll have to wait and see how true that is come the end of the release schedule. Either way, I'm not going to waste any more of your time. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Let me know what you're most excited about down below in the comment section. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.